Hi, we're going to discuss one of the non-probability sampling technique, that is quota sampling. Our discussions are divided into three points. They are: what is quota sampling, why or when is it used, and how is it applied. In understanding this topic, this is an example of a research question. So suppose this is your research question, then we will have questions in our mind. For example, are you going to collect the data or the information from all of the students in terms of levels? Because as you know that senior high school is divided into three levels: first grade, second grade, and third grade. And the second question is, how many students? It means all of them or not. There are two ways. If this is the case, in obtaining the sample, you may apply stratified random sampling or quota sampling. But you have to know the difference. Stratified random sampling is one of the type of probability sampling, while quota sampling is non-probability sampling. It means you have to make sure that you understand clearly the differences between probability sampling and non-probability sampling. Well, let's see. What is quota sampling? As I have already mentioned, quota sampling is one type of non-probability sampling. Non-probability sampling means the member of the population do not have equal chance to be included as the sample of a research. They don't have equal chance to be included as the sample. That is one point that you have to know when we talk about non-probability sampling. Quota sampling, it means it is an ease of access to sample population. So you as the researcher, you choose the easiest, the simplest way of how to obtain the data or the information from the sample. And in relation to quota sampling, it is intersected with gender, age, socioeconomic status, etc. It means, in relation to the research question that we have, talking about students can be divided in terms of gender. For example, female students or male students. In terms of age, and also in terms of levels, first, second, and third grade. When and why is it used? If we obtain or take the sample by quota sampling, when our research is, or it aims to investigate a trait or a characteristic of a certain subgroup. To investigate a trait is characteristic of a certain subgroup. It means students, as in our example, we divide them, it can be in terms of levels or age. And it can also, when your research is to observe the relationships between subgroups. For example, you want to compare the data or the information gathered from the first to the second grade or to the third grade. So that is the reason why you as the researcher take the sample by applying quota sampling. Once again, quota sampling is non-probability. Okay, the reason why a researcher chooses the sample by quota sampling is when the research aims to investigate a trait or a characteristic of a certain subgroup, or when we are going to compare data collected from different groups. Get it right? How is it applied? Okay, there is no fixed steps in obtaining the sample by quota sampling, but these four general steps can help you in obtaining the sample in terms of quota sampling. They are, the first step is you divide the population into subgroups. So you divide the students into groups. It can be age, it can be gender, it can be about levels. It depends on your research. The second step is figure out the proportion of subgroups to the population. After that, you decide the number of the sample that you want to take from the population, or the sample size, And the last is choose and collect the data from the participants or the sample, being careful to adhere to the subgroup population proportion. Let's see how these steps are applied in obtaining the sample relating to quota sampling. So, this is the research question. What is the average time of learning at home of the senior high school students of SMA Negeri 1 Dolok Sanggul in academic year 2019 and 2020? So, the first point, we have to know the population. So, let's say, because this is just an example, the number of the population is 900. So the first step is divide the population into subgroups. So we divide the students. In our case, we want to see the difference, information from the first to the second and the third. So now we're going to divide the students in terms of levels. So let's say first grade, there are 300 students, in which males are 100 and females are 200. While the second grade, this is also 300 students, males are 125, while females are 175. While the third grade, 300 students, males are 130, while females are 170. Now we continue to the next step. Figure out the proportion of subgroups to the population. It means, how many students that you want to take from the first level, second and third. In this example, let's say we are going to have 30% from the first grade, 30 from the second, and 40 from the third. Now, perhaps in your mind you have question. So how do I know, or how do I decide to take 30% from the first, 30 from the second, and 40 from the third grade? Well, the decision to take this depends on the researcher. It depends on you as the researcher, because this is non-probability sampling. It means, once again, the population doesn't have equal chance to be included as the sample of a research. The third step is decide your sample size. How many that you are going to take from the 900 students? Let's say, in our example, we want to have 10%. It means 10% from 900, we will have 90 students. In which, these 90 students 30% from it will be first grade, 30% second grade, and 40% third grade. Then we will have 27, okay, because 30% from 90 is 27, 27 and 36. Okay. Just do calculation. And after that, this is the last step, okay? Choose and collect the data from the participants, being careful to adhere to the subgroup population proportion. As I have already told you or mentioned that, okay, quota sampling, this is an ease, it means simple or easy way for you as the researcher to contact or to get the data from the sample. So in relation to our research question, you just choose, okay, which one for you that you think the best way, the simple way for you to collect the data. Let's say, okay, you may stand at the entrance into the school and interview the students, in which you have to interview 27 students from the first grade, 27 from the second grade, and 36 from the third grade. So that is quota sampling. Once again, that is non-probability sampling, okay, technique. The reason you decide to obtain or to take the sample by quota sampling when you are going to divide the population into groups. Okay? It can be in terms of age, gender, socioeconomic status, and so forth. Okay? The second reason is if you are going to compare the data from one group to the second group. In relation to our example, okay, let's say you want to know, okay, what is the average time of the first grade, what about the second grade and the third grade? That is quota sampling.